Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the DC Wilcutt Gymnasium here at CBC High School. We have a good one for you here, a good old-fashioned rivalry. CBC versus the Junior Bills from St. Louis University High School. We're glad to have you with us. Hopefully you're staying warm on a cold night. We certainly think the action here will help. Bringing you the game tonight, I'm Tom Eichwald, and alongside me, CBC coach Corey Bethany. Corey, nice to have you.
Nice to be here, Tom. Ready for a good, exciting basketball game. Good thing we're indoors, right?
It is a good thing this is not an outdoor sport. Now, Corey, your thoughts so far on the season for CBC?
You know, Justin kind of gave us a preview last year of playing tough opponents early in the season just to test and see exactly what he has. So the record is not doesn't look too good, but they only lost in the city of St. Louis has been to Chaminade. They're a good team. They're trying to find themselves and just understand who you know would take the leadership, missing the big Jordan Barnett, you know.
Right. So we're going to our public address announcer, CBC coach and chemistry teacher, Butch Dimovitz. So we're going to let you join Butch Dimovitz. When we come back, we will get you all set for tip-off. And we want to welcome you back to the Tim Kylo broadcast booth here on the Cadet Student Network. As we get set for tip-off here, Corey, what can we expect in this game? Let's start from the visiting junior. What do we expect from SLUH tonight?
Expect a lot of outside shooting. You got two guys on the court that shoot 40% from the three-point line. For a CBC, tough defense and getting the ball inside.
And I think you mentioned the defense. One of the things that's kind of been a little bit of a process for the Cadets, if you look at that Shaman, the highest profile game CBC's had, really struggled defensively. Now, granted, it's against a great offense, but the movement wasn't necessarily there. The head wasn't necessarily swiveling. So really look to see how CBC has improved in these big games. You know, these games against talented teams are one thing, but games against these MCC rivals, so much different just in terms of atmosphere. So look to see how CBC does tonight. Now, what do you think about some of the young players for CBC so far? You look at Jordan Barnes, obviously, great season last year. Mm-hmm. You look at Christian Willis, only a junior. But let's talk about the Jarek Powell's and Nick Wheeler's, kind of the players that have come in. Any thoughts?
Well, Powell is a senior. He set out last year, a lot of injuries he had from the track season and whatnot. So he set out, and, you know, it's nice to welcome him back. But Nick Wheeler's a good addition, you know, tough physical, give you that mean streak to come back in. You know, the tough guy to get the rebounds and play good defense.
And there you see Jordan Barnes getting himself on the score sheet tonight. And the first points of the game. So it is 3-2 to the Cadets. So 6:37 to go. This is Matt Nestor up top for SLUH. Passes it inside. This is B.J. Wilson. And ball touched out of bounds by Powell. It was knocked out of the hands of Hunter Schmidt. So 6:26 to go, and SLUH's got it underneath the basket. So this is just the first of our CSN broadcasts tonight. If you're joining us and hoping for a full CBC Sports, we can do that for you. We will be at the hockey game later tonight, CBC taking on DeSmet. So we hope you're joining us for the evening. And there you see the points for Schmidt.
You see right there, CBC trying to run him off the three-point line. You don't want Nestor to make those open shots. They're going to run him off the three-point line, but Nestor, being a good guard that he is, find the guy down low.
And here's Powell, kicks it out top to Wheeler. Wheeler to Willis in the corner, thinks about driving, loses control a little bit. Referee saying he stepped out of bounds. I sure didn't see him, but we'll give him benefit of the doubt. There by Brandon McKissick. So just under six to go, and CBC trailing 4-3.
Brandon did a good job cutting off baseline on Christian there. That's his favorite move, to power dribble to the baseline, and he did a good job of cutting them off.
And all the MCC schools certainly got a good look at Christian Willis last year, one of the key the run at state and the eventual state championship. Barnes the same way. But other than that, a relatively new look for CBC, obviously. And there you see the three-pointer for Davion Nash. But you mentioned the you talk about Jordan Barnett being lost. But you look at, you know, the your support players
your
as well.
Your role players, yeah.
Quinn Adams, Josh Webster. He was actually around today. Josh Webster got to say hi to him.
Yeah, you know, and it's early. It's early, and that's what Coach Tatum would like to do, is figure out exactly who are the role player guys who can step up in these critical MCC games and be used down the long run.
And here is Barnes. Now Willis. Willis pops the three. Can't quite hit it, and no attempt at the rebound. Schmidt gathers, hands it to McKissick. McKissick drives, draws about three defenders, kicks it out to Nash. Unable to convert on the three. Good rebound there by Jarek Powell, state champion sprinter as well, so you know he's got some speed. They're going to get Christian Willis stepping out of bounds again. Struggling to find the sidelines early in this one, Christian is.
Purple is not standing out to him.
No, it isn't. And, of course, CBC wearing some new white home shoes this year, so making it a little harder to get away with those on the baseline. You got white shoes, purple line.
Yeah, I didn't notice that.
Yeah, no more of the purple shoes, because they had the purple home shoes last year. And a good block.
Good two blocks.
Very good. Good to see good defense out of Kenny Leslie, something that's kind of improved as the season's gone on. And here's Barnes.
Freshman.
There's a freshman, Cale Ketchings, unable to convert. So 24 tries the shot, and 24 gets the rebound. Just the wrong one. Davian Nash. Now it's McKissick. Thinks about the shot, decides against it, passes it to Nestor.
Bad spacing there by SLUH.
Nestor, good pass down low. It's a great pass to B.J. Wilson III there. Great pass from Nestor. Good vision. It's kind of that vision of seeing through your defender, knowing exactly what's on the other side.
Yeah,
of him, so good movement.
Good time out there by Tatum. You can tell we're selling for shots on the offensive end and two in the paint shots for SLUH. He's really letting them happen right now.
So let's be a little more specific. What is he saying in there right now? Just what he said, or is he?
Yeah, like he's trying to hype in the tempo and let them get more active on the defensive end. You'll see a better defensive effort coming out of the Cadets on this one. And they're going to drive to the basket, probably get fouled. He wants shots in the paint. We're selling for the outside shots, and you want to get in the rhythm first before you start allowing those to happen.
And what do you think's going on in that SLUH huddle right now?
They got the momentum, so they feeling good about themselves. They walk in with their chest held high, you know. Nice 6-point cushion. They know they're working on to put the Cadets away.
We'll see how a 6-point cushion stands up in MCC basketball.
Yeah.
A lot of basketball to play, folks. Here's Kenny Leslie. That's Christian Willis with 3:54 to go. Now Barnes. Barnes very much the man for CBC this year. So the mantle's passed from one JB to another.
Yep.
Here is Barnes. Very different player, but same kind of expectations. Here is Barnes trying the three.
That's out of his range. You would like to see him at least pass it in within the.
And there's a free shot for Nash, and he hits. Barnes a little slow to close there.
Yeah, same results.
And we'll see here. Barnes is the man with the ball right inside. Good pick from Leslie. Finds Catchings. Catchings drives. And he can't get the layup to go. And a good rebound there from Wilson.
You need to attack the basket on that one.
Now Nestor drives. And they're going to get Barnes with a push. So Matt Nestor will be shooting two. And we get to catch our breath with 3:05 to go. 12-3 advantage for the junior Billikens right now. Things very much going their way. And here is Nestor at the line. His first drops. So he's 100% from the line tonight, Matt Nestor. He is. I'm getting glares from our producer here. That was he's one for one. That's 100%.
100%. Quick math there.
That is.
He's 89.1% on the season.
That's more impressive math.
Yeah.
Maybe now he's about 89.14 or something like that. But he converts both of them to make it 14-3. By the way, I mentioned our producer. We want to thank all of our students making the broadcast possible tonight. We got William Kratz. We got Henry Hines running errands for us before the game. John Rolfe. And certainly Bryson Schroeder.
Matt Nestor with a block on a 3-point attempt by Bomarito.
Bomarito into the game. And there you see the attempted shot from Hunter Schmidt gets knocked out of bounds.
Ball. Kenny Leslie with 3 blocks already in his first quarter.
It's been impressive, but the only reason he's needed to is because if you look at the possession, I think SLUH has probably had, this might be the soccer commentator in me, but we're talking probably 65-35 possession right now. SLUH has had the lion's share, to say the least. So under 2.5 to go now. Nestor leaves it for McKissick. McKissick's got a little time. It's Brent Smith trying to turn.
Yep.
And he's caught traveling. And it's going to go the other way. So CBC with a chance to try to get something with 2:21 to go. CBC faithful reminding the SLUH players that traveling is against the rules in basketball. It's not one of the sports where you can run in possession of the ball. That's exactly what they're saying. And here is Brandon McKissick. One-on-one with Willis.
Just threw it up. Oh, they called a foul.
Yeah, I thought Willis just stood his ground, but apparently went into him a little bit. So the foul's called against Willis. And Brandon McKissick is at the line. 2:04 to go, 14-3. And he misses the first. By the way, folks, in case you're craving MCC basketball, relax. CBC versus Chaminade on January 23rd will be CBC's home game, but it will be hosted at Lindenwood University. You can get tickets again. That's January 23rd, as you see McKissick hit the second there. The game will be hosted on January 23rd at Lindenwood University. Tickets will be on sale at CBC during next week's games. DC Wilcutt tournament, of course, next week. But the 23rd, CBC versus Chaminade, round two. Chaminade got the win in round one, but you want to see how CBC rebounds. So that will be one to circle on your calendar. So January 23rd, be sure to be there. Lindenwood University. See next week at the Wilcutt games. Here you see the foul drawn by Cale Catchings. He's going to go to the line. We're going to see Christian Willis make way for Nick Wheeler.
Good pass inside by Christian there.
Better attempt to try to get a little penetration, just get in the paint a little bit.
Absolutely. Freshman got to knock that down, though. You know, take the contact and get an and one. Or get at least one.
Yep, at this point, as you see him miss the first. Shooting 0% from the line tonight. And here's catching second. And that one doesn't drop either, and McKissick easily gets the rebound. Everything going SLU's way right now. 15-3 with 1:40 to go. And here's McKissick, one-on-one with Blake Bromarito. Spin move and a travel. That one did drop, so two points spared by the travel. Now here's Barnes. Will anything be different here? Wheeler tries to set a pick, doesn't quite pan out. And CBC moving around the outside. Bomarito. Wheeler.
Again,
good pass inside.
Again, see the difference? The freshman couldn't make the layup. Wheeler being a receiver on a football team. Nice hands through the catch and the paint. Strong enough to go up for the layup and get the and one.
And he's a thick fella, too. I think it's going to take a little more than a little arm slap to knock him off.
Absolutely. But good catch down at least the basket.
And a great pass from Willis. You got to give him credit. I was just about to say CBC unable to find that one pass, and they found it. So you circle that one and come back to it. So with 1:18 to go, a 10-point game, Nick Wheeler at the line, trying to make it nine.
That's back-to-back sets. They ran that like a motion. Pick and roll action, high low.
And here's the and one. It goes. So it is a single digit affair. And you mentioned Nick Wheeler, a wide receiver. Of course, congratulations to the CBC football team on their state championship. And Coach Bethany,
yes,
our color commentator tonight. He is the offensive coordinator. So we want to thank him for all of his work and give him the credit that is due.
Little half-court trap dashing there on the defense. Oh, off the glass by Bourne. Should have got the foul on that one as well.
Yeah, he took a pretty good shot to the shoulder. You see some tape on his left shoulder. It looked like he took a direct blow to it. You saw him kind of hold it.
Man, he kissed that high off the glass for 2 points.
So 42 seconds to go.
Good trap there on Nestor.
They've got Nestor.
Oh, and he travels.
And he travels.
Shuffle the
feet. He was trying to call the timeout, but CBC wouldn't let him do it. They were all over that ball, and he grabs the foul. So Wheeler in with 35 to go.
Pick and roll game there. Foxworth within the game. His first game, first action. Since being hurt.
And here's Barnes hits. And there you see the fist pump. CBC back in it. Now 11-15. CBC only down stoppage at 13.2. I think we got Coach Claggett has a question. Not sure exactly what that was, but it's going to be SLU's ball.
Now, they shouldn't allow this substitution in.
Because it wasn't a timeout.
Because it wasn't a timeout, and it should have been a dead ball, I guess.
Now, how do you explain the stoppage there, Corey?
I don't know.
Is it just Coach has something to say?
You could tell Claggett was shocked by it himself. Like, you know, what's going on? So, look at the defense by Willard.
Oh, all over him. And McKissick gets the free shot, takes it.
Oh.
That's impressive. And he gets the and one, too. They're giving him the and one. He motioned for it.
No. What the ref did there was telling the scores table to count the basket. It was
okay.
A successful point.
Okay.
At the buzzer. So.
I think McKissick thought it was maybe a foul too. He was waiting for the ball around the free throw line.
Well,
so.
I tell you, those two guys can shoot it. Number three, McKissick and Nesser. You know, they both above 40% in shooting behind the arc.
Break here. We're going to take you to a word from one of our sponsors. When we come back, we'll have second quarter action here on the Cadet Student Network.
This is CBC Athletic Director Rocky Strub, and if you know me, you know I love to eat. One of my favorite spots is the Cafe Afton, the home of the CBC burger. The owner, Craig, is a huge CBC fan, and he always treats me right. Located on Gravel Road, the Cafe Afton is a great place, or for any occasion for that matter. Just ask my wife. I'm always looking for an excuse to pay Craig a visit at the Cafe Afton. I know you'll love it too. Please be sure to tell them that you're a CBC fan and that Rocky sent you. That's Cafe Afton, home of the CBC burger, located on Gravoy Road.
And we're back. We want to welcome again. We got second quarter action. SLU up 18-11 at DC Wilcutt Gymnasium.
Worst shot. The think about that. Shot at the end of the buzzer. They get the ball to start the second quarter again. Alternate possession rule in high school.
And here is McKissick. One-on-one with Barnes. Two impact guards going at it. There's a good little bump from Schmidt. Created some space for himself. Back to McKissick. Up to Nash up top. Can't get it to go. I don't think it would have counted anyway.
What they call there?
I don't know. They didn't allow the shot, so it wouldn't have been good.
Call a foul on Powell.
So that'll be SLU's ball under the basket. And see substitutions being made.
Tell you what, this SLU team is not afraid to let it fly from the three-point line.
They are not. Well, they've had good success. I mean, you look at in the end of the first quarter, pretty much sums it up. And yes. Another travel on Nestor. You can tell he's getting frustrated. He's been absolutely mauled twice and traveled.
Suffocating defense by the Cadets there.
Yeah, maybe a little more time in the weight room for Nestor. I don't know if he's losing his footing or what. And here's the inbound. Barnes bringing it up. 7.5 to go. 18-11. Needing something right now if you're CBC. Had a little run of momentum right there at the second at quarter. Real important to keep that going right now. You don't want to let SLU run away with anything.
Ah.
And there's the pass inside. It's knocked out of bounds by B.J. Wilson. The pass was clearly for Kenny Leslie. Wilson knocked it right out of Leslie's hand and out of bounds.
Wheeler need to get that pass a little down. Kind of sailed on him.
Here's Barnes. Now Willis. Willis taking his time. Letting everything set up in front of him. Starting lineup out there, except Sam Orff is in for Jarek Powell at the moment.
Oh, he pulled him. Missed call by the officials. Ball thrown out of bounds by Sam Orff. He pulled Kenny's arm, on the box out.
It's defensive holding in football. And here's Nestor.
Almost travel again there.
Yeah. Corey Gilbert on the other end of that one. Now Nestor, one-on-one with Sam Orff. Beats him but can't beat Leslie. Pass it inside for Schmidt. Schmidt passes up top. Here is Gilbert. Can't put it in, and good rebound by Nick Wheeler. Willis Barnes. Kenny Leslie creates a little bit of space. He's going to try to go a baseline on Schmidt.
Almost stepped out.
Does, but can't put it in. Ball bounces out. Now McKissick trying to round the corner on Orff. Good job by Orff moving his feet, preventing him from doing that. And cross-court Gilbert was completely unmarked.
Oh.
CBC recovers. McKissick to Wilson. Up top, Nestor. Nestor drives. Runs into Wheeler. McKissick gets the shot off.
Good jump.
Great physical rebound from Christian Willis. That is strength right there. And here's Barnes taking the shot. He hits it.
In rhythm.
Unfazed, Jordan Barnes. That is what you want to see. Up to 11 points tonight. First player in double digits.
Yes.
All but three of the points for CBC.
And those other three came from Nick with the and one. I would like to see Kenny. Good help out there in travel.
Another travel.
Good help there by Nick Willard to double team down in the paint.
Talk about physical defense just disrupting SLU on the ball. That's been impressive. Was that the fourth travel now caused by a little physical defense? Is that the fourth one?
Yeah, I believe
three from Nestor and now one right there. Here's Barnes. Leslie.
Attack.
Leslie, that's not what you want to see.
He can knock those down now, so he's not your typical big man. He's more like a swing, a wing guy.
Here is Willis. Tries to do it himself.
Ball. Draw the foul. Man, when he dribbled, you can just, it's like thunder. Doom,
you can feel it from up here.
Yeah.
We're wearing very heavy headsets. We can hear that one. So 4:50 to go. CBC trailing by four. Trailing by as much as 11 in this game.
They calling that on the floor as if he wasn't taking a shot.
I guess it was in the run-up to the layup. That's what they're going to say. I think Coach Tatum looking for a little clarification. Finally gets it. And things as they are, we're inside of 5 minutes. While we have a second, we want to ask you, Cadet fans, are you protected? Call State Farm agent CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim is more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of CSN. We are incredibly grateful for his support. So give Tim a call, 314-842-4442, or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. So again, send him an email at tim@timkylo.com. Or give him a call at 314-842-4442.
Tim was a sponsor of our tip-off, too. We failed to mention that.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we are in the Tim Kylo broadcast booth, so certainly we want to thank Tim for all of his support. And here's the inbound from Sam Orff. To Kale Catchings, a sophomore to the freshman. We'll probably hear that combination a few times over the next few years.
Yes.
A lot of potential there. And Sam Orff, got to give him credit. Played a role as a freshman last year. He takes a nudge, pass it to Powell, and Powell can't finish. Can't put it away, and SLU gets the rebound. But to finish the point about Orff, played a part last year, wanted to get better. I tell you, every single morning this fall, my parking spot's right outside the gym, I would walk by, and Sam Orff is in the gym by himself before school every morning, shooting, dribbling, and just working on his game. It really has been impressive all semester in the first semester.
Yeah, Coach Tatum.
To watch him trying to get better.
Another block there by Kenny there. That's four for the game.
And here's
Orff. First half. Yeah, Coach Tatum talked highly of Sam Orff as he shoots the three there, short.
Good poke from Powell, but Willis unable to gather, and it falls for Nash. Now Gilbert.
Stolen.
Interception from Willis, who's one-on-one with Nash. Lays it in. So CBC now within two, the closest they've been all game.
Good body control there by Christian Willis.
Very good. So with 3:33 to go, Nash, Gilbert. This is Staff. And he hits.
Better come out on the big fella.
Yeah, he hits for three, so in a CBC down, now down five.
Seems like they all shoot from three.
You think they practice that a little bit?
A little. Miscommunication there between Kenny and the freshman.
Yeah, toss it out of bounds, and it's going SLU's way. As is the game at this point, although CBC closing the gap. Again, 5-point gap, 3:11 to go. We want to let you know that when you need an attorney, you want someone you can count on to protect your legal rights. The attorneys at Milliken Wright are here for you. Brian Milliken and CBC grad Chris Wright have fiercely represented the injured and accused in civil and criminal cases in the St. Louis metropolitan area for more than 15 years. Call Brian and Chris at 314-621-0622 or find Milliken Wright online at www.millikenwright.com and let Milliken Wright fight for you. Good rebound there from Foxworth. And
look,
Barnes hits another one. He hits another one.
Oh, yes.
Boy, did you see his dad over there on the other side?
I didn't.
I think he's a little excited. I think we got the full standing exclamation point.
Good block there by Kristen.
Nash, that thing didn't have a chance. And Kale Ketchings on the rebound. And we're going to get a foul going against SLUH.
Yeah, he had his arm caught inside there.
Yeah, that was Staff, Spencer Staff. Senior forward, 6'5". And Nestor makes Gilbert. And Leslie and Orff get a breather. So Foxworth in, Bomarito in, Willis, Barnes, and Ketchings. Now Ketchings, Barnes. Bomarito.
A lot of screen in there. Tough shot.
Tough shot. Great rebound again. How about the strength and body control we've seen from Christian Willis tonight? That's another impressive one.
Yeah, he's very tough inside. Great body control, good hands, way to finish around the basket.
And that's only 4 points for him. It's been an impressive 4 points, I got to say.
Gamble there, but good help defense by the Cadets. And ball staff, loose on the floor.
Staff couldn't control it.
They want to get Fosworthy. Big Paul's getting in there, getting dirty.
Yep. So Foxworth picks up his first foul of the game, and it's going to be SLUH underneath the basket.
Foxworth is another guy that came in. Didn't play last year, and now being a part of the team coming back, I don't know what his layoff was, but nice to see him back on the hardwood.
And you saw the referee giving a little talking to Staff and Ketchings there. There was some shoving going on. Now,
man,
if you ever listened to a CBC soccer game, you've probably heard me talk about the shoving and the referee warnings in soccer. That was exactly what happens on a corner kick in soccer. Two players, they're pushing.
Yeah.
The referee comes in, gives the universal gesture of knock it off.
Cut it off.
And we go on. So, familiar sight.
Both players trying to gain leverage.
Well, and honestly, I like seeing that because the alternative, obviously, is to give a foul. You can't give the foul one way and not the other.
Right.
Just warn the players. They're young. They're excited. Tell them to calm down. Tell them you'll call it next time and just let the game continue. I like good officiating right here.
That's an offensive foul on Foxworth. Not quite sure what he did there on the screen, but they're keeping an eye out on him.
Here's Staff.
Oh. Good defense. Give me that ball. Just give it here. You don't want it, I'm taking it.
Is that a steal
nice,
or a
strong,
block?
Solid
I don't know
seal.
What that is.
I
he ripped it out of his hands in the air.
He's giving the good old football coach all pumped up. There's a lot of body contact down there.
And here's McKissick. And Foxworth gets it again. Willis, good pass to Ketchings.
Oh!
Ketchings
okay,
takes
they
it
had,
back.
They had to call that one.
Well, that's the same two players, Staff and Ketchings. I think Staff was a little eager to give Ketchings a little piece of his mind there.
I think it wasn't intentional. He was going for the block, but goodness, a lot of contact going on.
We
came to a basketball game and watching a MMA fight.
That ball and into his face, I got to say. That's quite the motion. So Ketchings at the line, 0-for-2 so far. Now 1-for-3. Goes from batting zero to batting 300 in one fell swoop. A lot of baseball players love that one.
Absolutely.
Here is Ketchings. He hits the second one too. So now 500.
Turnover off the inbound.
Barnes goes up. Little touch.
Almost a finish by the freshman.
He was up way above the rim there. I wonder if that wasn't going in before.
I'd leave no doubt.
No, leave no doubt, of course.
Clear everything off the rim and send it back home. Just fell off the miss.
That would have gotten the CBC crowd excited. CBC crowd, of course, going with the All-American double dip tonight. We mentioned the game later tonight. They're going to that right after this. As you see, a good put away there from B.J. Wilson. But CBC crowd in their American Stars and Stripes tonight. What is more American than spending a Friday evening watching high school sports? So you'll see the jerseys, the flags, the lovely Uncle Sam hat on varsity soccer team's Jake Stumpf over there. So I want to thank the CBC now.
We got a tie ball game here.
We do. 23-23, 30 seconds to go in the half. Here's Nestor. Now McKissick.
Still will try to hold for the final shot.
Hold for about 20 more seconds here. Nestor thinks about cutting inside. Passes it back out for Wilson. Nestor again. Matt Nestor been very involved throughout the game so far. Drives, cuts back. McKissick finds Nash in the corner with six to go. He misses, and put back from Wilson fails. Kenny Leslie grabs the rebound. 1 second left. There's the lob. He had the distance, but the direction wasn't so good. And that's going to do it. What a half of basketball we just saw. 23-23 at halftime. We're going to go to a break. We'll let you hear from sponsors here. When we come back, we'll have a couple things for you. We'll wrap up the first half, get you set for the second half. Cadet Student Network.
Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. And the State Farm team provide a full insurance review to make sure you and your family are covered at the best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-442, or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Call State.
And we got a halftime ceremony for you. This is the presentation of the state banner for CBC. So we're going to take you to public address announcer Butch Dimovitz. Apologize, we missed the public address there, but Coach Butch Dimovitz just saying what a pleasure it was to watch this team, talked about the team effort we saw last year, and certainly when you look at the season last year, you can talk all you want about Jordan Barnett, the season he had, and the state game he had. I mean, 40-plus points and 20 rebounds is no average game. But really just a complete team. We saw the team buy in. We saw the team fight for each other, and everything that we heard, saw, and felt around campus was really focused on that team. Your thoughts on that team?
Like you said, they were a complete team. I mean, guys over there now, you see Josh Webster, Jalen Wallington, you see Quentin Adams, and I can't make out the other one. Look like Armand Watts, but yeah, they all played a key role in winning the state championship game, and what a game it was to go into overtime, and they were a complete team in rotations. Jordan Morris fouled out in that game, and you know, you had to rely on Josh Webster and people like Tyrus Lockhart to bring it home for the Cadets. So, I mean, it was a magnificent game, a great team. A lot of people didn't expect them to be in this situation that they were in last year, and they believed in themselves. And they got it done. So it was a good journey, a good team, all around team.
And I have to say, you know, I've been to a lot of high school sporting events, and I don't think I've ever had more fun at a game than I did at that basketball game.
Yeah, it was.
Now I also don't think I have chewed off more fingernails in a basketball game. When that three went in right at the end of regulation to tie it and send it into overtime, your heart sank.
Yep.
You thought, the CBC lost all the momentum, and it was going to be ride.
It's all about. It was a great game. Once you get to that championship game, you hope and dream that it's everything that it would be, and come out victorious, obviously. But to have a good game and the one that everyone's around St. Louis and the state of Missouri to even talk about and continue to talk about, what a phenomenal feeling that is to actually come out on top on that.
It really was. So congratulations again to the 2014 state champion basketball team. Now, we shouldn't forget to mention that CBC currently at this holding state championships in basketball, hockey, and football.
Yep.
That is a tremendous credit to the athletic department here at CBC. And just, okay, we talk about what they do on the field. I don't know if you realize, folks, if you tonight, public address announcer Butch Dimovich, probably the best defensive coordinator in the state of Missouri. You've got Coach Scott Pingle, CBC varsity football coach, enjoying the game. CBC varsity golf coach Mike McCormick working the book tonight. Basketball coach Matt DeGrief also down there at the table. You've got varsity soccer players supporting varsity basketball players. Everybody is on one team here. It really, really is impressive. So if you game, come see it just so you see all these faces supporting each other. It really is a tremendous going on at CBC.
The most impressive about that three different sports holding state championship games is they're all different kids too. Usually when you go to the high school, you got phenomenal athletes, and they win it in football, they win it in basketball, they win it in track. But these are different group of kids on each sport. You know, you may have one or two of them play both, like the Armand Watts and the Nick Willers tonight. So, but they sport and they actually win it, and that's impressive.
It really is. So a lot of good things going on at CBC. We mentioned the athletic things, but that's not all there is. So we want to send you right now to an announcement about a campaign that helps you support everything we do here. It's called Stand Up for CBC. So we're going to play this for you, then we'll talk a little bit about it, and then we will get you set for a second half action here.
Stand up for CBC, stand up for community, I said stand up for integrity, stand up for CBC. I am one, not the only one, who can do everything. What I can do, I will do, by the grace of God, for my school, God, for us all, Christian brothers on the move. Stand up for CBC, stand up for community, I said stand up for integrity, stand up for CBC, stand up.
So there you have it, an opportunity to help CBC stay around for another 165 years. We're very proud of the run we've had. We want to keep it going. So we thank you for all your support in the past, and we want to encourage you to consider continuing to support CBC. We also would be remiss in that video if we didn't give credit to our jazz band who provided the music, and our Brothers in Harmony chorus who did all the singing there. So everything was completely done by CBC students. So I want to thank everybody involved and invite you to stand up for CBC. So with 3 minutes and 38 seconds left, CSN would like to thank a few more sponsors here, like the Lab Gym on Manchester Road, Milpaw's Piping and Supply, Let's Party Now Catering, and Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas. These loyal businesses make this broadcast possible, so please be sure to support our sponsors. Again, the ones we mentioned, Lab Gym on Manchester Road, Milpaw's Piping and Supply, Let's Party Now Catering, Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas, and so many more. The CBC Alumni Association, our admissions department, also sponsors CSN, and we appreciate their support. If you would like to sponsor the Cadet Student Network. You can find information on our website, and you just got to contact Tony Kosiolek, our assistant athletic director. You can find all the information online, but Tony Kosiolek is the guy you need to talk to about getting these announcements on CBC. We'd be happy to endorse your business. You can contact him at 314-985-6048. 314-985-6048. That's Tony Kosiolek. Give him a call. We'd love to read about your business here on the Cadet Student Network. So, Coach Bethany, bring you back in here. Your thoughts on the first half?
I think CBC started off slow. And SLU had the momentum the whole first half until towards the end. And CBC fought and clawed back in. Outstanding performance by Jordan Barnes. He is the reason they're in the game right now, even, you know, with 14 points. So I would like to see Jacob play a little bit more, Nick being a lot more physical. I would like to see Kenny Leslie get more, you know, some of those shots would fall down, I believe, in the second half. So low scoring first half. It's competitive. It's everything that we expected.
So the minute and 40 seconds to go here before a tip. What do we expect in the second half? So let's say let's look at both scenarios here. So Coach for SLU. Now you've been in you coach basketball as well. You've been down there in games like this. For a team that had all the momentum, started to run away with the lead and then gave it up. What are you telling your players right now if you're Coach Claggett?
Well, they're a young team. They're a very young team. So they're going to have up and down games. They're going to have games where they are feeling good and they're feeling confident, and then they're going to have moments in the game where they're not, they're, you know, they're traveling and getting frustrated and having dealt with the pressure of, you know, a state champion CBC's team.
Right. And on the other side, having chased down SLU, the intensity you talked about, the defense players need to get more involved on offense. Last things you can say if you're Coach Tatum right now before you head out on the floor.
Let's be us. Let's be us. No shots will fall. Continue to play high-pressure defense and, you know, take smart, good open shots.
So there you have it. We got about 20 seconds. Teams are going to take the floor. And I should add to the canon of coaches present, new CBC coach Cornell Robinson making an appearance. Love people watching at CBC games. It really is a pleasure. So the wrestling program is well represented here, supporting these. So as we get set, we saw a first half that was intense, well officiated, and we're ready to go. So CBC will start with it. This is Jarek Powell. CBC going out the way they started the game. Leslie, Willis, Wheeler, Barnes, SLU also. McKissick, Nestor, this is Wilson, Nash, and Schmidt. So we're underway. Barnes is going to bring it up, one-on-one with McKissick. Been a fun matchup to watch so far. And here's Leslie. Talk about him needing to get more involved, get some shots to drop. That one doesn't. Willis is able to get one up, but it doesn't go. And here's Nestor with the ball. They can't make him travel that time. And here's McKissick. He's going to drive. Ooh!
I'm not sure who to give that credit, that block to.
I think Leslie might have gotten a hand there first. Honestly, with arms as long as his, it'd be pretty hard for him not to get there first.
I mean, Willis, as high as he jumped, it was – can you give half blocks in basketball?
I don't – to my knowledge, I don't believe it's like sacks in football, but –
Let's give them both.
We'll call it a team block. How about that?
Yeah.
Team block.
Give them both.
And here's Nestor. Wilson inside.
Good help defense on the backside.
And I think they're going to get give him two shots. I think Wheeler took a little swipe at him from behind. They're going to get him four. So it's going to be two shots for B.J. Wilson, the third. Still at 23. And, of course, you see basketball without the fans encouraging the opposing players on the free throws. CBC senior Max Beffa, the free throw specialist for the CBC crowd. They call him out of the crowd every time. Why? Very good at coming up with random things to say.
That is Coach Beffa.
Coach Beffa, I apologize. A key member of the coaching staff.
Absolutely.
For the state champion football cadets.
He supplied the rest of the coaches with gum every single practice, every single game, every single half, it seems.
He often also was often a probably when they didn't want any gum.
He was also a vital part of the signaling on the offense. He would signal in the plays, so appreciate his help.
And his involvement in the athletic program continues even into the cold of winter. Barnes with a spin move.
Again.
Tries to pass it through. Not exactly a high percentage pass. Wilson, he's going to drive. They're going to get Leslie for goaltending.
Yeah.
I guess they said he touched the ball. I didn't think he touched it. I guess he must have gotten a fingertip to it.
Well, he slapped the glass and caused the whole rim to shake. Looked like he's shaking up. He's shaking his right hand there. Hopefully he didn't cut anything.
Well, I think the backboard looks okay. Here is Willis. Can't get it to go. Falls for Nestor. McKissick breaking on the far side. Here's Nash. He's going through Jarek Powell. And we got conflicting reports from the officials. One says charge. The other says block. Now, I don't know how you can say that Powell didn't have it.
She was in the stands right now, right behind
him. Well, and honestly, Paul actually is. Powell had his feet set for about 3 seconds.
Yeah, he did.
There
Absolutely.
Is no doubt about this one, I don't think.
He's going to call defensive block.
That's...
Oh, okay.
They're going to call something...
It's offensive.
Okay, it is offensive. All right. That is the correct call. We don't often say that there's a clear wrong and right, but on that one, I think they got that one right.
Yeah. CBC starting off slow again in the second half. I was kind of shocked about that.
Trailing five here. It's 6.5 to go. Catchings inbounds to Powell. Leaves it for Barnes, and it's Barnes versus McKissick again. Mm-hmm. About round 25. Willis. Good
High
pass
low.
Over the top
Bush.
From Leslie. And they're going to get, looks
Smith.
Like, for a little shove in the back of Cale Catchings. Very good call.
He's a veteran refs too, by the way.
Yeah, really good job by the officiating crew tonight.
Yeah.
I got to say, there haven't been too many really dubious ones. And here is Willis, and he puts it away. Good rebound from Christian Willis. Boy, the scoreboard kind of lies. I think Willis only was 6 points, but he's been very instrumental for CBC, having, I think, a pretty good game. You know, a few things haven't dropped for him, but really I think he's been nice and involved.
He's very active around the boards.
One of those games where the stats really do justice. Here's Nestor, find Schmidt. Sorry, Coach, you were going to say.
No, not yet. You know, it's a game of basketball. It's all about rhythm and, ooh. Like Powell
ooh.
Almost gave him a.
And McKissick certainly not making any friends with CBC. Runs into Jarek Powell, then trips Jordan Barnes.
I think Barnes slipped first, and then the contact came. So I mean,
McKissick just wanted to make sure he got to the ground safely, of course.
It was accidental, but
it was.
You still have to call it.
Yep. If for no other reason, let the players know you're going to protect them.
Yeah.
We're not
going to
let that kind of thing go.
Here's
Leslie. There's the
try.
Dunk. That's what we've been wanting to see on offense from Kenny Leslie. So
yes.
The big junior puts one away. Big senior, correction.
Senior, yeah. Good baseline drive there for the two-handed dunkaroo.
I would compare notes on the two-handed versus one-handed
dunk.
Oh,
we got another travel.
That's they pushed him. I was going to say, compare notes on the two-handed versus one-handed dunk, but both are pretty far from my realm of experience, so I think I'll stick to just telling you that it happened.
Well, two hands is always more powerful.
But it doesn't always look cooler. It kind of depends
on
the circumstance.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Because
but
sometimes when the shoulders are squared to the hoop, obviously you can get maximum pull, you can bring the legs up, and it looks real cool. But when you get the one hand coming down, you know, and you can really unwind.
Travel. Yes.
World's slowest travel signal there.
Worm got his signature traveling call on that one.
I guess so.
Timeout by SLU.
And so CBC with 28-27, just under five to go. We want to let you know that if you want to maximize your athletic potential, you can join world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym on Manchester Road. That's world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym on Manchester Road. Matt Miller and his team train high school, college, professional, and even Olympic athletes. He gets you ready to compete at the highest level. Mention the Friends of CBC discount offer, and you will receive a two-week free trial of sports performance training. So again, that is the world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym on Manchester Road. Talk to Matt Miller. Tell him you want the Friends of CBC discount and get 2 free weeks of sports performance training. Call Matt at 314-932-7270. That's 314-932-7270. Or visit their website at labgym.com/sports. And here is Willis. He's going to get things started. And he finds. Here's Leslie. Takes the baseline drive. You know Slew's thinking about that now. Yep. He's showing him why. As he goes up over his man, that was B.J. Wilson.
Rebound.
And Catchings can't put it away. Leslie
Big
dives and gets
ground.
It. And it's going to be going CBC's way. I think Slew a little bit of travel when he's sliding with the ball. You saw Matt Nestor look over at the official and give the travel gesture.
Yeah. You like to see a big man get down. Oh, quick.
Now, is
quick
that a travel, though, in your eyes?
But
he
never had full control of the ball, so okay. That's why they didn't call a travel there. If he had the ball, he had possession of the ball,
then
and he fell to the ground, it would be travel. But it was a loose ball. It was a hustle play by the Kenny.
Here is Powell, leaves it for Willis. Good pick from Leslie. Now Catchings.
Brandon is playing really tight defense against Jordan.
Barnes finds a spot for the shot. He gets it away, and McKissick gave him a little nudge in the gut when he shot that, and I think Barnes let McKissick know he didn't appreciate it. Or
Man.
He said, go ahead and do that again. I'll make it.
Letting him catch, and it was a nice screen. Jordan got free, and that's all he needed is that little space to knock down a three.
So those were points number
17,
15, 16, and 17 for Barnes. Here's Willis, one-on-one, shoves McKissick out of the way. I think it's brought down by Nash, and they're going to call a travel. All that contact, and they get him on a travel. That's like getting Al Capone on tax evasion. What? That's what they got him on.
I think
yet again, our production staff is shaking their heads at me. And you know you appreciated that. Deep down, somewhere. While this commentator continues to be proud of that one, CBC now has the lead.
It's Nestor.
And they still have it, although by one. So McKissick and Barnes starting to get a little chippy between the two of them.
McKissick
run into him. Barnes gave him a little shove, told him to get off. Be interesting to see where that's if that pants. Oh, why didn't that shot go in? Why did that shot not go in?
Oh, man. He just slid about. He almost hit the mat there. He almost hit the state championship banner on the wall. Defending the crossover by Barnes.
That is why Barnes is an important player right there. Wow. Brandon McKissick might want to keep his mouth shut for the next few minutes. I think whatever jawing he was doing is probably going to come to a stop for a little bit right there.
I'll tell you what, that's going to be all across America.
Here's Willis, intercepts the pass, finds Barnes.
Oh, my goodness.
Who hits the three over none other than McKissick.
And,
that's
and,
a, That's a rough 10 seconds for Brandon McKissick.
Brandon doesn't know what to do. He's shaking his head like, Coach, I'm doing what I'm doing.
Boy, I think Barnes might offer an autographed shoe after the game.
Jersey swap or something.
Yeah, then he gets knocked down by Foxworth and doesn't have the points to show for it, but he's going to get to the line. I guess we'll see how rattled he is here when he goes to the line.
Man, and Jordan is letting this guy know, like, look, you cannot guard me.
You know, and we were just saying it's starting to get chippy. These two guys are starting to go at it. Well, I think we've settled this. I think we may have just determined who's going to come out on top there. McKissick does put that one away, so starting to regain his composure. And did you notice that his teammates are congratulating McKissick on the shot? Barnes walks through the teammates.
He want to go right.
Just putting the thought in his head.
You're going to have nightmares of me tonight.
Wow. This is fun.
And the CBC
crowd. Fans asking McKissick how his ankles are.
Nice to know they're concerned about the.
Well, it's all about the safety of these kids.
Yeah.
And here's McKissick catchings. And I think Nash is going to try guarding Barnes for this one.
Brandon didn't want him. I don't think Nash won him.
No, I don't think anybody does. Here's catchings.
Good attack.
He's going to drive to the hoop.
Good
the
attack.
Freshman draws the foul.
See, I like that. He had an open shot, but he saw a lane through the basket, and then he draw the foul.
So with 2:22 to go, CBC with a one-point advantage, 33-32. The third period, third quarter, certainly has been fun, third period. It's like I'm already calling hockey. That's not for a couple hours, folks. We do want to remind you, though, in case you missed it at the beginning of the broadcast, we will be bringing you CBC versus DeSmet live from Queenie Ice Rink later tonight. That game's at 9:45. Yours truly and the CSN staff will be bringing you our second game in a night, so you can make an entire evening of CBC Athletics. Whether we see anything as cool as that move, we don't know.
Spencer has four fouls. Spencer staff for SLU now. Four fouls, so that's huge.
That is the number 35. He's one of the big men, too.
Yeah.
He's about the biggest guy we've seen out there. He and Schmidt. And good put away there. First points of the game for Brent Smith. And now Willis. CBC still up by one. Ball goes out off of McKissick's ankle. McKissick's belabored ankle. Watching Larry Hughes over in the corner enjoying this one as well.
Oh, yeah.
And here is McKissick. He misses it.
Missed the layup. Missed everything.
And the CBC fans are going to enjoy that one. McKissick's a very good player, but I think the CBC fans are they've identified him as a target.
Well, is he only a sophomore.
And so is he going to get a technical there?
No, it's a hold.
Did he say something? Okay.
It was holding Barnes.
Hold, okay.
Good call, and Barnes knows right away that's a one-and-one.
Don't see much contact there, but it was enough.
McKissick going over to Irwin. Say, hey, I can't guard him, so I got to hold him, right? Yeah.
Coach, I'm not saying get me out of here, but what do you want me to do? You're going to leave me out here. Help me out here.
I'll tell you what, though. To be a sophomore, he's an impressive player.
Oh, we'll be seeing a lot more of him in the next few years. Barnes is a junior, so this is going to carry over to next year at least.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm sure the AAU circuits as well.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he may play a grade under, you know.
Good shot from going to get another one. The referees liked his first attempt, so they want to see it again. We want to see it again. So 36-34 with a minute 38 to go in the third here. And make that a three-point lead, 37-34. Here's the inbound from SLU. McKissick finds Nestor, who returns the favor.
Full court
pressure. No, you take it. Here's Nestor, drives to the hoop and parts the seas of Jared Barnes and Kenny Leslie, and he's going to lay one in.
Good pass. Yes, good
very
body
good.
Control. It's nice with the head fakes.
And Barnes finds Powell. Catchings. Back to Powell. Minute 10 to go. 1-point lead. Powell's able to turn. And he's going to draw the push. Fake the pass to Catchings. And he's going to win possession back for CBC Corrections throw, or a shots. He's going to go for two.
Hit the ground hard.
Yes,
came
he
up
did.
With a limp.
Powell looking for his first points tonight.
Oh, that was way off.
I'll have to wait another one. He's not happy with that one. Coach Tatum giving some instructions to Leslie and Barnes. So the minute to, a minute two to go. Powell's second free throw does drop, so he's on the score sheet now with 1 point. And now Nestor did well last time. He's going to get it again. Drives on Powell. Leaves it for McKissick. Now Nestor.
Good
defense. Tries to go through. That's not going to happen. And a timeout to Coach Claggett. While we have a quick break here, we want to let you know that if you're not protected, you can be. Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim is more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of CSN. And we are incredibly grateful for his support. Call Tim at 314-842-4442 or send him an email at tim@timkylo.com. So we got a timeout here, 44.1 to go. 2-point lead for CBC, who have trailed most of the game. If you're just joining us in the second half, it was certainly an eventful first half. SLU got out to a lead. CBC caught up and now has taken the lead, but certainly not a safe lead by any stretch of the imagination. 44 seconds to go in this one. Buzzer sounds. Players take the court. And while we have one more second here, if you need an attorney, you want someone you can count on to protect your legal rights, the attorneys at Milliken Wright are here for you. Brian Milliken and CBC grad Chris Wright have fiercely represented the injured and accused in civil and criminal cases in the St. Louis metropolitan area for more than 15 years. Call Brian and Chris at 314-621-0622 or find Milliken Wright online at www.millikenwright.com. Milliken Wright will fight for you.
Oh, another timeout forced by the Cadets. Get the ball in within the 5-second rule.
SLU certainly hoping those don't come back to haunt him. We're going to let you hear a word from one of our sponsors real quick, and when we come back, we'll have more basketball action here on CSN.
World-class sports performance at the Lab Gym, St. Louis's premier training facility for elite and developmental athletes. Do you want to maximize your athletic potential? Do you want to get bigger, faster, stronger, more powerful? Prevent injuries? From high school and college to professional and Olympic athletes, world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym will get you ready to compete at the high level. Call Director of Sports Performance, Matt, at 314-932-7270 or visit their website, labgym.com. Or just stop into the gym at 5035 Manchester Avenue to see for yourself.
Hey guys, this is Matt Miller, world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym. Make sure to check us out online, stop by, get a free tour. If you mention you're a friend of CBC, you get a 2-week free trial. So come get better, maximize your athletic potential.
And welcome back. Ball was just inbounded. You didn't miss too much here. And here is... this is McKissick trying to regain some pride and composure. In case you missed it, you'll probably want to go back to about the middle of the third quarter and see the move that Jordan Barnes put on him. Not only did he fall down, he went sliding about 8 feet out of the way. Here's Nash's shot. It's good. So that's a big three because that regains the lead by one. So SLU is going into the fourth quarter with a 1-point lead and setting us up certainly for what should be an exciting quarter. Anything you think coaching-wise needs to happen here, adjustments for either team?
It's not really any adjustments right now. I mean, one key note to look at is foul called on SLUH, CBC would be going to the stripe to shoot free throws. So that's a plus in CBC favor. You know, when you think SLUH is going to tank and CBC is going to come back with a huge three to to get back into the game. So, I mean, they up one now. I believe they get the ball coming out of to start the fourth quarter. And
although it's exactly what a rivalry game should be, essentially.
I mean, going in, you know, close contested game. So, no surprises here.
Two teams mastering this one.
You got to believe if you slew, though. You enjoy. you want the last second shot. As, you know, we had a buzzer beater to go the first quarter, the end of first quarter, and we had a buzzer beater to beat the third quarter. So,
well, you want the last shot, and you probably don't want Jordan Barnes taking three-pointers.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
He's been deadly. He's the leader in the game.
22 points.
And here's Schmidt. Nash. Nice move by Nash. Finds B.J. Wilson, who dunks one to extend the lead to three. I think the SLU fans like that one. Just a little bit.
Yeah. It's a good pass.
Great pass.
Damian Nash.
And here is Bomarito. Now catchings. Barnes. Barnes being marked by McKissick again. Willis slows things down. Drives, tries the fadeaway, doesn't work. McKissick wins the rebound, but out of bounds, so it's going to be CBC's ball under the basket. Again, trailing by three here. Both coaches up and about. Justin Tatum for CBC, Irwin Claggett for SLU. You know, I actually got to play golf with Irwin Claggett and James Washington a couple years ago.
Oh, really? Nice. Really? Drive, baseline.
Great guys. Very, very pleasant, very jovial. Although certainly not in a situation like this. Sorry, you were saying.
No, it was a good drive by Barnes. Missed the layup, but Kenny get called for over the back on that one, his first foul of the game.
And whether you make the layup or not, you're at least putting it in putting it in your defender's mind that you can do that. You're adding it to the options that he's got to consider. So even if it doesn't work on that occasion, he's thinking about it now.
Oh, he traveled.
A little bit of a travel. I think Coach Tatum saw that one. The referees didn't.
He dragged his back foot, his pivot foot.
Tatum's about 4 feet on the floor, letting the ref know about it. And here's Nestor.
Tough shot.
Beats inside. Barnes, but can't beat the rim. Trying to reach over the top of Kenny Leslie, which takes a lot of reaching. And it's going to be CBC's ball.
Now they go 1-1. Yep. Like I say, any foul against Junior Billikens is going to be a 1-1 situation.
Well, and you've just got a 3-point lead. Be careful about that. I mean, it's a rebound under your own hoop. Why are you going over his back or nudging him? Like, I get you want the rebound, but that's kind of a silly foul, really.
Yeah, it really is. And you never see that foul call for one. It's Kenny making play. Make them count. Hit your free throws. Play solid D. You can come out here with a MCC victory.
Leslie checks his shirt. Make sure it's properly secured. And here's the second shot. Game. It's good. Nothing but net, both of them. And here's Nestor. 1-on-1 with Powell.
Oh.
Good defense by Powell. And ball comes all the way out to the top to McKissick.
The count is on.
And here's Nestor. Back to McKissick. Over to Schmidt. Schmidt finds Wilson.
They're going to have to get a call.
Did he do it again?
Yeah, he did. On Wilson Jr.
Wilson did, okay.
Yeah. Barnes.
Oh, he took a little nudge there on the way through. I'm not sure the official saw that one, but he did take a little nudge on the back. You could see accelerated a little unnaturally at one point. I know he's got some acceleration, but usually the small of your back doesn't accelerate faster than your legs do. So either way, it's CBC ball. Catchings goes up for it, can't put it away. And catching, and Nash keeps it in bounds. Nice job. Nestor can't quite control it, or he does, actually, and finds Nash. And for once, the big three doesn't drop.
I know. He usually looked good from here.
Willis took a nudge on the back, too. And he's not happy he didn't put that away. I think Tatum's saying, you got to watch that shove. That's two now, he's saying.
They're just leaving everything short at the rim.
I think for Catchings, you know, Cale Catchings, of course, a freshman, very impressive freshman, not only, you know, talent-wise, but also physically.
Yeah.
He doesn't look like a freshman out there.
No, not at all. He's, but he's good size.
But really needs to work on his finishing. I mean, we've seen any number of cases where he's down low, takes a little bit of contact, and it's he's not able to find the hoop. I mean, you look at the opportunities he's had, and he's sitting on 4 points right now, so certainly something I'm sure that his coaching staff will work on with him, I would imagine.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, each year he'll get better, without a doubt. I mean, he's only a freshman, and he'll gain the confidence and then put those in the rim, I mean, in the hoop.
And while we're talking about the freshmen, let's talk a little bit about the future of the team, because you have juniors, seniors. The senior count is really low.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you look at the seniors for CBC on the varsity roster, okay? Jarek Powell, Blake Bomarito, and Kenny Leslie. Everybody else is a junior or sophomore or freshman. Yeah. So, I mean, you look at the talent coming back. Willis, Barnes, you know, Orff, if he continues to develop. Catchings, if he continues to develop. You know, younger players, Avery Merriweather may play a little more prominent role next year.
Yeah.
Jacob Foxworth, only a junior. So, I mean, really, you got the next few years are looking very bright for CBC.
Absolutely. Program, so you get these guys in here, get them playing young, and develop them. By their senior year, they should do something special. Haven't seen a lot of Nick Wheeler in this second half.
And here's Willis. 41-40. Pelicans. Barnes now. Thinks about the shot, finds Powell instead. Barnes gets a little bit of space, passes it right into the face of Cale Catchings. Kenny Leslie bails him out, drives to the hoop, and doesn't put it away. I think he slipped a little bit, but still you'd expect him to put that one away. I think he'll be a little frustrated. A lot of points left on the floor for CBC tonight inside the paint.
For both teams, a lot of missed shots. 40-41 game, you'd think it'd be a...
And they're going to get Cale Catchings on the travel. A bit unlucky there. Ball kind of bounced. He had to catch it while his feet were moving. So nothing you can do there. It's going to be Slew's ball. Schmidt's going to inbound looking for Nestor. Nestor's being guarded by... And here's McKissick. Here is Schmidt. Good move, and he makes it, and they're going to give Kenny Leslie the foul there. So the and one for Hunter Schmidt. And that is Kenny Leslie's first foul. Good rebound from Catchings. Great rebound from Catchings. He has some ups, folks.
Yeah, he did. Already.
And that's about twice you've seen his head about rim high.
Yeah, almost had a dunk, a putback dunk.
Willis pulls back within one. 3:45 to go in this one. Slew up by one. Coach Tatum applauding his team, urging him on.
Someone needs to step up besides Barnes, and it looks like Willis want to be that guy.
And there it is again, another rebound.
Yeah.
Willis impressive on the glass tonight. And here is Barnes. Cuts back outside. Now Willis again. You see the quick ball handling from Christian Willis. Shows you he's meaning business here.
Nice.
Leslie converts.
Oh, and he, gets,
and
the
he gets the one. So CBC with a one-point lead the line to try to make it two.
No, they call the off-the-ball foul. Count the basket.
Get him.
So, okay, so Hunter Smith committed a foul
on Cale Catching. So it looks like we'll be one-on-one on this.
Yes.
So here's Catchings, one-on-one at the line. So 44-43, one-point lead. The freshman with a chance to extend it.
Coach Klagen didn't like that call at all.
Nope.
But looking at Smith, it looked like he, you know, yeah, you got me, you got me. You know,
yep.
and both players ended up on the ground, so.
And that is Schmidt's fourth foul of the game. So Schmidt with four, Stapp with four. And he's going to stay out there, Schmidt is, so he's going to have to be careful.
So it was a loose ball foul, and since there's 10 fouls on SLUH, it was a double bonus, so that's why the two free throw attempts.
So now CBC 45-43, two-point lead with 3:11 to go. Here's Nestor with Powell again. Good quick feet from Powell. And he hits one. There's the big three they've been looking for. So now 2:54 to go. SLUH with a one-point lead.
I'm telling you, every time SLUH get CBC get the momentum, they come back down and hit a big three and put them right back in the game, if not up.
Willis.
They missed Fosworth inside. He had a great seal. And you think you want to go at the big man with the four fouls.
There's Barnes. Pulls the three, and he drains it.
He's unconscious.
He is unbelievable tonight. That's point number 25 for him. 25 points. The next highest number I see up there is 13.
Oh, we got an injury.
That's Kenny Leslie holding the ankle. Catchings is going to come in for him, and they're going to call the trainer in and the coach. And is he able to put weight on it? Not very much, it looks like. He's having trouble. Didn't exactly see what happened. He's kind of holding his foot. He's going to walk off under his own power, but very gingerly, so you hope Kenny Leslie's all right. And while we do have a quick second, we want to ask you if you know a grade school student who might be interested in being a future cadet. Please encourage him to pay us a visit and experience CBC for himself. A shadow visit is the best way to learn more about the great things that are happening at CBC every day. Seventh grade shadowing is now available. Please call Mrs. Melissa Ryan to schedule your shadow visit or a private family tour of CBC today. Call Melissa Ryan at 314-985-6095 to make plans to pay us a visit. That's 314-985-6095. Spend the day with us and experience what CBC is all about. There's the inbound. Willis leaves it for Barnes with 2:11 to go now. Tie game, 48-48. And Coach Corey Bethany, this is what high school basketball should be, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, MCC, tough game. You know, you're going against your rivals. Both teams scrapping it out. Let's see who comes out on top.
You get the impression it's just going to be maybe one.
Look at Barnes.
Wow.
He's putting on a show.
27 for Barnes now. I was about to say, you get the impression it's just going to come down to, you know, one mistake, one missed shot, one made game like this. It's
back and forth game, all game.
Somebody's either going to make a mistake or somebody's going to do something extraordinary. That's probably the only thing that's going to separate these teams. And there's a foul called on Foxworth. Or correction, Barnes. I saw the four, I just didn't see enough of them. I saw too many, rather. 1:30 to go. And while we have a second, I just want to take one more opportunity to thank all the students who have made this broadcast possible. CSN brings you not just sports, academic events. theater performances, band concerts, choral concerts, everything that's going on at CBC, we want to bring you here on CSN. And we want to thank our students who made the broadcast possible. Just looking around me here, just great group of kids. We got John Rolfe behind me. We've got Charlie Hines over there, William Kratz. We've got Bryson Schroeder, our fearless executive producer. Also, Alex Somm down there on the camera, and Henry Hines. Had to run an errand, had to run a Radio Shack for a cable before the game. Did it, made it back in time. Didn't get pulled over for speeding, so we want to thank them for all of their work. We certainly couldn't do this without them. So the Cadet Student Network is really made possible by our students. So thank you, boys, for all that you do. And as we come back, we have another minute and a half to go. Which, as you know, in basketball, doesn't mean a minute and a half. 2-point lead for the Cadets, thanks to a lovely little touch lay-in from Jordan Barnes,
who has 27. Well, I don't believe any other cadet are in double figures.
No. I mean, if you look at it, he scored more points than the rest of the team combined.
Yeah, over half of them.
And Wilson can't get three to go, or the free throw to go. He's going to get another try.
I'm telling you, this SLU team is pretty young. He's another sophomore, 6'7" sophomore.
CBC fans jumping up and down. And the ball going through. Good, so it's a 1-point game now. Willis bringing it up. And Kenny Leslie is back on the floor, so he is okay, which is certainly good to see.
Good to see.
Tatum called a timeout just to give him a little extra time, I think. You want him out there. Probably primarily for just his defensive ability. We saw some phenomenal blocks in the first half. And we're at the 1-minute mark.
Looks like
right now
CBC is content to keeping the ball away.
And they're going to hold it for a little while. Willis finds Powell. Leslie. Catchings. Takes a little bit of a hack, but gets his rebound.
My goodness.
Attacked again, so Catchings is going to go to the line. That's Matt Nestor with the foul. Only a second, and a reminder here that Hunter Schmidt, number 25 for SLU, is currently sitting on 4 fouls.
Get in there.
A little short, but it goes. 2-point lead.
One thing in that, the coaches, the whole coaching staff jumped up and yelled at Kenny Leslie on that. And he dished it off, and you wouldn't think anything of it. They want their senior to finish that play. And that they want him to get that leadership and take the team under their wings and finish that play. Not pass it off to a freshman who you saw miss the layup. You know, who got the rebound back, making his 2 shots, but don't even give that ball in his hands. You take control of the game.
And Bomarito is going to come on for Powell. 45 seconds to go. CBC with a 3-point lead thanks to a pair of free throws from Cale Catchings. Makes it. In the face of some major distractions there.
Still 100% too.
CBC's crowd, yeah, still 100%. Now more than 2 shots though. And Nestor, will he stay 100% and make it a 1-point game? He does. That is clutch from Matt Nestor, junior guard for the junior 52-51 CBC. And you're going to get a foul against McKissick. And this means 2 shots for Barnes. Huge opportunity here.
Yep.
Make both of these. All of a sudden, it's a 3-point game again. Not like SLU is a team that can make a clutch 3-pointer when called upon. And that one rattles out. So at best, it's going to be a 2-point lead now. 41.9 after this free throw.
I was shocked to see no CBC cadets on the in the lanes, and I guess Tatum was too. He was like yelling at them to get in there to possibly get a rebound.
All right, so timeout to CBC. CBC again up 53-51. We want to thank all of our sponsors. I want to thank Tim Kylo. We want to thank the Lab Gym. We want to thank Guido's. We want to thank so many other people who make this broadcast possible. Millican Wright Law Firm, of course. Just so many supporters of the Cadet Student Network. We could not do this without you. So thank you, thank you, thank you for your support. Now, okay, we got a timeout here. Two-point game, 41.9 to go. What is Coach Tatum telling
you? He got to defend and not foul. You want to run him off the three-point line. Play tough D, and don't foul. Each team has one timeout left, so if you slew, this'll be an interesting call. Do you stall and try to play for the last shot, and get a wide open three, or call a timeout once it gets down to 14 of 10 seconds, or do you go ahead and play basketball throughout?
Well, we'll see. We shall see. Regardless of what happens, this has been a lot of fun. And we do want to let you know that even after basketball is over, you can continue to join us on CSN at Queenie Ice Rink. We're gonna grab this equipment and sprint over to Queenie. And by that, I mean drive in our cars safely. But we will head over there to bring you CBC versus DeSmet on the ice.
We lost it.
Turnover from Nestor. Here's Willis.
And
a foul and one. It's a foul from B.J. Wilson III. Willis is fired up. That makes it a four-point game. Could be a five-point game with 30.6 to go. What do we say, Coach? It was going to come down to one made shot or one missed shot.
Yep.
And it could very much be decided by that one right there
and
from Willis.
He just lost the ball. He just lost the ball. Wasn't fouled. Good pressure defense by Powell. He's in all his stuff.
After, and there it goes. So a five-point game now with 30 seconds. And Nestor, he's had a great game. He's been great from the line. Just made those two clutch ones. So certainly a cruel twist of fate for him. Here's McKissick. He's going to get fouled.
Man.
Boy, that's a bad time for that. So he'll be shooting 1-1. Barnes fouled him. Again, a five-point game. That's not what you want. 22.5 to go.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to foul and allow them to get points.
Well, in fact, that's the only thing you really can't afford right here.
Allow them to get points with the time, with the clock stop.
If somebody tries to do something and makes a mistake, that's one thing, but a foul, that's the one thing you can't allow here. And McKissick is at the line. First one is no good. Willis gets the rebound. Willis doesn't let him foul him.
They're going to play
15 to go.
Surprising.
Kenny Leslie puts it out.
There's the dunk.
There it is.
He was passing that one.
Boy, that puts an end to this one. That is an exclamation mark on this one. And with 5 seconds to go, McKissick's going to try to get some pride. Can't even put it away.
No good.
And that's CBC. What a game from the Cadets. So you got to credit Christian Willis there for the layup and drawing the foul. You credit Kenny Leslie for the dunk. But the man of the match, there is no doubt about it. All 28 points goes to Jordan Barnes. We would love to sit here and talk about this, folks, but as we mentioned, we got to haul this stuff over for some hockey. We're going to hope to carry this momentum. So I want to thank Coach Bethany for joining us here. And for all of us at CSN, I'm Tom Eichel. I want to thank you for joining us for this one. Give us about an hour, come back to us, and we will be bringing you some hockey. Thank you. We will see you in a little bit.